The first question is if Rinpoche promote or support vegetarianism and why?
Actually, myself, I'm not vegetarian, but I'm really support to vegetarianers, the person who, due to the compassion to the animals, I'm really appreciative for them.
Why Rinpoche is not a vegetarian, if I can ask that question?
This, there are many different situations for different people. So some are due to health, they need some meat. Some are they since they are young, they eat meat, so they're used to it. So for my case also, yes, I used to it, so I just like take some little bit meat, so only that's the reason.
Should Buddhists and Buddhist monks encourage vegetarianism?
In Buddhist, we say if someone we killed animals for meat, or we order kill animals, or if someone killing animals, we rejoice through this actions. So then, and this is this is negative actions. Otherwise, during Buddha's time, all the his monks they go to barefoot, so they carried lungsi. Lungsi means whatever get in, they have to accept. So if vegetarians, they keep vegetables, they have to accept. If some non-veg, they keep some meat, they also have to accept. So but in that's in kind of Hinayana teachings. They're not much, how to say, forbidding on eating meat. But then in the Mahayana, then there are some teachings this may be forbidding about taking meat.
Which are the benefits of being vegetarian and the faults of eating meat?
I actually, in the Buddhism way, most is depend on the our motivation. If motivation is really due to compassion to these animals, then that is the those beneficials. So without this kind of motivation, benefit to others. And yes, some people they don't take meat for their health, or some people they don't take meat because they think meat is very dirty. So these are, even though they are vegetarian, there's no benefit.
Is it a compassionate and respectful act to eat the flesh of slaughtered animals? If not, what are Rinpoche's thoughts on Buddhists, spiritual people, and religious people choosing to eat the meat of animals who have suffered so much, while we can have a plant-based diet?
Actually, if we eating meatless, we already dead. So it's like eating, kind of eating flesh. So if they eat or not eat, it doesn't, there's no difference for that pass away. So in Vajrayana Buddhism we have especially mantras, mantra of Avalokiteshvara, like this. There are lots beneficials and blessings. So even if though we eat meat and before we pray on these dead beings, and this also can benefit those dead animals rather than how to say harm them.
If by buying a stolen product you become an accomplice of the crime, so well, I think that if you are buying the meat of a slaughtered animal, you are buying a stolen product too. So you are becoming an accomplice too, because they stole the body and steal the life of that being. So Rinpoche does agree with that, or has anything to comment about?
Yeah. So if we order to kill the animals, of course, then you get the negative actions. Yeah. If we already killed, we eat this meat. This is actually no such negative act. And then suffering animals is not only the cause of meat, and there are many different things, like skin or their bones or their horns or whatever. So also especially most animals, they are suffering with torture. So I think this is the most problems.
Yeah, but those problems, they come from by you ordering, or I mean not ordering directly, but by you being a consumer. Yeah. So I'm not sure if my understanding is the same as the Rinpoche, because even if you don't order, but they are killing to you, mm-hmm. not directly, but still it's to you because you are the consumer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, according to Dharma, cause and result. Without cause, you cannot get this result, or karma. Act and karma. If I don't kill someone, I don't get the bad karma of that killing. If I don't practice dharma, or I don't commit any spiritual virtue, then I don't get the benefit.